Hello traders, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Well, you have seen the today's market was completely disaster. Why? Because Nifty fell down more than 400 points. Bank Nifty fell down more than 1200 points. Well, how did it happen? Why did it happen? Which stock moved the market? Before analyzing all these things, let me tell you why today market has fallen. Well, I already expected that Bank Nifty will fall, but I didn't expect that Bank Nifty will fall that much, means 1200 points. Why did I say that? Because if you've seen my last video, in my last video, I told you that Bank Nifty will fall on Monday. I did the analysis of the data. I just saw some news. I did the analysis of meetings and open interest data as well. Thereafter, I came to know, okay, Bank Nifty is indicating that it is going to fall. But I'll not take entire credit that I told you so that Bank Nifty will fall. That's why Bank Nifty has fallen. Well, I told you that was a little part. Means I was expecting Bank Nifty to fall 400 to 600 points only. I was not expecting that Bank Nifty will fall more than 600 points. Well, why did it fall then? When I was making my trades, I did some news analysis and I came to know that new strain of coronavirus has been detected in UK. So all the flights from UK has been cancelled. So why? Because if new strain is coming in other countries, then it might be possible that it will come to India as well. And it is also possible that the vaccine which we have developed for COVID-19, which will not work for this mutant virus. So in that case, what will happen? Well, again, travels will be banned. Then inter-country business will be affected very much. FIIs are putting too much money in Indian's market because they were expecting that now market is recovering. Corona vaccine is going to come and everything is going to fall in line. But now this is suddenly a big news. If big news is happening, it means big companies are going to be affected. If they are going to be affected, means they are going to make less profit. Means foreign people will not be able to invest in India now. If the news, this new strain comes along with the business, in that case, we have to be extra careful. So that was the major reason. If you say, why did it fall too much? Well, Nifty has fallen more than 400 points. It is Nifty weekly range, if you see. But today, it just broke all the record. Okay, and I was also stunned because I have taken some calendar spread trade. And I was trading consciously and I was thinking, okay, it has gone 200 points down. So now it can go maybe 50 points further down and then it will stop. But when UK market opened, at that time, this other countries market affected our market very, very badly. Means if you see up to 12:30, Nifty was down around 200 points. And when it has just moved from 12:30 onwards, it has started going down more and more. And if you see from 2 to 3:30, then Nifty has fallen down more than 200 points. Well, I made loss today, 12,000 loss. Why did it happen? Because when I was making the trade, I exited from particular trade wherever I have made the calendar spread for one quantity. Then I was thinking maybe, okay, Nifty have moved enough. Now it will move maybe 50 points only. Then I just kept my mobile like that. And then when I picked up my mobile at 3 o'clock, I was stunned because there was 12,000 loss. Well, still that loss is not like a huge loss to me because I can recover that money within a month. Okay. So then again, I'll be recovering the money within my, but again, I have gone back 1 month because I'll be taking 1 month to recover that money. So still, if you see here, I have bought some insurance as well. Means whenever I put the calendar spread, I decide my losses as well. That will be acting as my stop loss. So that's why I didn't lose much. Means if I would have sold negative call options or put options, then definitely today it would have fallen. And I would have been occurred loss of around 2,50,000. That incident would have wiped off all of my capital. But that is the power of trading. Because if you are suspecting that market is going to go down, then don't buy naked put or don't sell naked put. In buying, there is a limited risk. Means whatever premium you have paid, that might have been lost at the end of the trade. But if you are selling options, then there is a huge risk involved. That's why they say that option selling is risky, means it involves unlimited risk theoretically. That's what happened in today's market. If you'd have sold put and market has gone down, at that time you were not in on your mobile and you were not tracking the market, then what would have happened? Your entire capital would have been lost. So that is where we have to be conscious. Well, I am making all the analysis, maybe Indian market, FIIDI, upcoming meetings, open interest, chart analysis, but still I missed something. And today I realized, what was that? Well, what did I miss? I missed the market news of other countries. So if anything big happens in other countries, it will definitely affect our market. So while making video, maybe it is possible that at that time the incident was not there, but once I made the video, thereafter incident may occur. So what I am thinking now onwards, whenever a big thing happen, I'll be making a shorts, means on YouTube, so that my audience can be well aware of what is going on in market. So whenever a big move happens, I'll definitely post short on my YouTube channel, so that you will be knowing why Nifty or Bank Nifty is falling. Now let's move to the chart and find out support and resistance. Well, still I'll be saying that VIX is very high, means it is around 23 today, so it is comparatively going near 25. I am again and again telling you that if VIX is high, don't sell the options, because there major losses can occur, because there is a lot of fear in the market. If lot of fear in the market means lot of volatility in the market, in that case you will say, okay, I'll sell and I'll put stop loss. Well, stop loss will not work, because there will be a big move, big changes, so your stop loss will hit in a minutes. So that's why I'll tell you, please don't trade. And even if you try to trade, do take the covered calls maybe. And tomorrow also, I'll see the market for a while. If I find it stable, then only I'll invest. Otherwise, I'll stay away from the market. If you see here on my screen, then support is at 13,127 and resistance is at 13,419. It is Nifty what I'm talking about. I have taken 15-minute candle. I cannot take more than 15-minute candle, because even if I'll take the 30 minutes or 1 day or 2 days candle, whatever support and resistance I'll be getting, that will not of weekly support and resistance, that will be of monthly or quarterly support and resistance. That's why I don't take higher candles. And why don't I take lower candles than 15 minutes? Well, if I take less than 15 minutes, then there will be a lot of false signals. I want to avoid false signals. What do I mean by false signal? Means lot of people trade in the market, so at that time they make lot of positions, so they receive the data from the server of NSE. So the data sometime arrives lately. In that case, what they do? Well, based on that lately received data, they make the trades. So in that case, there is a lot of disturbance will be there. So this is the safe place where we take the 15-minute candle. And out support and resistance for Bank Nifty as well. Here if you will see, then support is at 29,332 and resistance is at 30,387. We can't say anything about the Nifty or Bank Nifty by looking at the chart alone. We'll be doing the analysis further in our graphs and we'll be finding out support and resistance. Then only we'll be able to say something about this Nifty and Bank Nifty as well. This is the move of the market. Well, why did Nifty or Bank Nifty fall down that much? Which were the stock which has fallen down huge, so that they have impacted Nifty and Bank Nifty? You already know the news. So let's find out which were the stock. Well, when I was doing the analysis of market movers, then I was completely shocked, because there is no stock, there is zero stock which gained today. Maybe even 1% or 0.1%. None of the stock gained today. Every stock has lost only. When I was doing my analysis, I was come up with these names. So these were the only stocks which didn't fall less than negative 3%. They have also fallen, but all the stocks has fallen, and all stocks has fallen less than negative 3% except this stock. Which of these stocks? Well, Infi, Nestle India, Hindu Lever, TCS, Kotak Bank, Cipla, SBI Life, HCL Tech, Asian Paint, Reliance, Britannia, Maruti and Ultra Cement. What was the reason? Well, the reason is here. The new strain dubbed VUI 2020-12 first variant under investigation in December 2020 is said to be 70% more infectious. I'm talking about coronavirus new strain. New strain means this virus got mutated and now it is more infectious. Okay, so that was the news, and every stock has fallen today. So there was no stock which gained, so we can't discuss anything. All of the stocks fallen because of this new strain detected in UK. So when UK market opened, it affected Indian market very badly. Now let's move to the next and see which are the upcoming meetings which are going to be held tomorrow. So if you see here, then these are the upcoming meetings. If these companies are somehow related to foreign market, then definitely these companies are also going to be affected. Let's see what kind of news they bring in tomorrow's meeting. If it will be positive news, then definitely these stocks are going to gain. But the gain will not be too much because people have lost hope. Whenever people lose hope, Nifty or Bank Nifty will fall for consecutive days, maybe 2 days, 3 days. That we have to see. And if people are also expecting that this new strain recovery will be possible within months, then only people will be buying in stock market. Now let's find out in tomorrow's market. First we'll be doing the analysis of event as well, so that we'll be knowing what are the events which are going to be held tomorrow. So if you see here, then these are the events which are going to be held on 25th of December, 31st of December. So now let's move to the next and see what is VIX and what is the change in Nifty and Bank Nifty. First, let me discuss the VIX. VIX is 23.19. Well, it is low because it is less than 25, but still it is very high if you compare it with yesterday's VIX. It has gained almost 4%. If VIX is gaining, then fear is increasing in market, then volatility is increasing in the market. Then whoever is selling the options, they are in bigger risk until unless they are taking covered calls. So if they are not taking covered calls, then definitely they are going to lose the money. That's why I say that if VIX is low, you can earn money without any major losses. But right now VIX is high, comparatively speaking. Now it is not a good strategy to sell options. Just wait for a minute and see the market, how it reacts tomorrow. Then only you sell the options. If you see the Nifty, then it has fallen negative 432 points. Bank Nifty fallen negative 1258 points. It is a huge move. Huge move. Okay. So this both has fallen. Now let's move to the next and do the analysis of open interest. If you see here the Nifty total open interest, then more call has been sold if you compare it with the put. And here you can see the significant difference. How much difference is there? It is 2.5 lakh contracts difference is there. It is very huge difference. So if that much difference is there, then definitely nobody can take market up. Still, maybe they will try to take the market up, but it will not happen. It will not be easily recovered. Okay, if that much huge difference is there. Now let's see what was the today's market saying. Well, today's market is like that. Here also there is a huge difference, almost 2 lakhs contract difference between put and call. So call has been sold more than put, and how much more? Well, it is 2 lakh contracts more. So that much difference cannot be covered within days. Okay, so definitely Nifty is indicating that I will completely go down, both weekly and today's picture as well. And it also indicates change in open interest, indicates today's picture, and it also indicates how market is going to react in next trading session. So now let's move to the next and see our Bank Nifty picture. So if you see the Bank Nifty here, if you see, then how much difference is there? Here also you can see the gap of 2.5 lakh contracts between call and put. So more call has been sold. If more call has been sold, then definitely Bank Nifty is indicating that weekly I will go down. That is total OI, and it is very huge difference. If you see the change in OI is also seeing the same picture, because there is also 2 lakh contracts difference, and that cannot be compensated in a day. Okay, so people are still expecting that market will definitely go down. There is no positive news. Okay, so still I am expecting that tomorrow also market will go down only. Now let's move to the next and do the analysis of open interest distribution of Nifty, and we'll be finding out support and resistance. Well, earlier if you have seen this, then resistance was at 14,000. Today it has moved to 13,800. And where is support? Well, support is here, which is at 13,000. Still people are expecting that this much range is there, and open interest is building up on call side. It means people are expecting that Nifty will go down. I'm saying weekly picture. This is our support. Support is at 13,000, resistance is at 13,800. So 800 points gap is there. Now let's see change in open interest picture of Nifty, and we'll be finding out support and resistance. So if you see here, then where is support and where is resistance? You cannot find support anywhere. That much fear was in the market, means Nifty can fall any points. That's what people were expecting. They were not selling put actually. They were expecting huge move on put side, means they were expecting Nifty will go down. That's why they were not selling out of the money. Hence, you cannot see here any support. Only resistance is there. Resistance is also at 13,500. Again, open interest is also building up near this. So you can see that people are expecting that Nifty will go down only. And there is no chance that just like that it is going to go up. Now let's move to the next and see Bank Nifty move. Means Bank Nifty open interest distribution. And here if you see, here the resistance is at 30,500 and support is at 29,000. Still you can see the support is very nearby, because 29,000 it is at. But if you see, the open interest buildup is happening on this side is huge, means on call side. So people are not making positions on put side and they are not selling put right now, because they are expecting that Bank Nifty might go down. But still there are some people who are trying to match this level. Means if you see the difference between this 29,000 and 30,500 contract difference, then still they are making the positions. So Bank Nifty has fallen enough as per my opinion, maybe because tomorrow it will fall, but not that much, okay? Because as per the support, it is visible that 29,000 will be the support. Well, again, we'll be analyzing this support and resistance of open interest, change in open interest chart, and we'll be finding out of final support and resistance at the end of the video. So don't worry about that. I'll be giving you clear picture at the end of the video. Now let's move to the next and see the change in open interest picture for Bank Nifty. If you see the change in open interest picture of the Bank Nifty, where is support and where is resistance? This is your support. That is S1. Where is your resistance? This is your resistance. But if you see on the resistance side, means on call side, there is a lot of open interest buildup is happening. Why? Because they are expecting that Bank Nifty will go down. Today also they were expecting, because market has already gone down and there was new strain of corona news was in the market. So they were making the position on call side, selling the call basically. And still 29,000, some people have made their position at 29,000. But this support will not be held as per my opinion, because there is a lot of fear in the market and people are expecting Bank Nifty to move down. So whoever is making position at 29,000, they will definitely square off the positions and they will move their support down. So this S1 will go down. Now let's see the cash activity of FIS and DIA. If you see the cash activity, means equity activity, FIS and DIS, what they did today, both of them have reduced their positions. Earlier DIS was selling. Now today they have bought somewhat, because now again this price of every stock has come in buying zone, so that's why they have bought some of the stocks. So they are just accumulating the stocks, and once it will go up, they will start selling. Well, FIS have reduced their positions too much, and they even sold 323 crores worth of stocks. The DIS has bought 100 crores more, but still the net effect is negative, because there was negative news in the market and they are not making huge positions on buying side as well, okay? So they are just accumulating these stocks so that they can sell in future whenever the price will be higher, means overvalued price will be there. Now let's move to the next and see FII future and options activity. Here if you will see, in future market they are selling, means they are expecting that in future market will go down, and they have reduced their positions in options as well. So how they are making the positions? Well, they are selling in future. So what they are expecting, that future may market will go further down, and they are buying somewhat in options in call. So they are taking covered calls right now, because they are also not sure that till how much time this scenario will remain and Nifty or Bank Nifty will go down. So that's why they are making covered positions basically. Now let's move to the next and do the analysis of final support and resistance. Then FIS also today started selling. They have sold 324 crore worth of stocks today. They were continuously buying, if you have seen my last month and this month's video. But today they have started selling. That's why there was no point where Nifty could stop. Means nobody was buying. So if nobody was buying, definitely everybody is selling and Nifty and Bank Nifty is going down. Well, if you see here, then DIS have bought today, because it was their buying zone. So if you see the latter part of the day, means like after 3, Nifty was just going down, and there was one point where just people have started buying and Nifty has somewhat gone up, okay? Otherwise it would have been 500 points negative. So now this is the buying zone for some people, that's why they are buying. And if you see the future activities, FIS are continuously selling. month till date also they were selling, and today also they were selling. So if you see the options, in options only they are buying. They have bought heavy actually, 1245 crore worth of contracts. So maybe they were buying put. That is what I am sure actually, because they knew that the market is going to go down and we are only taking the market down in cash. So here we can earn money if we buy the put. So that's why market has gone down. And then this DI has come into picture and they tried to do the loss of this FIS. Okay, that's why they were buying if you see today's picture. Otherwise they were selling continuously. So that's what happens in the market. Now let's find out final support and resistance. If you see here, then final support for the Nifty is 13,000 and resistance is at 13,800. Final support for Bank Nifty is 28,946 and resistance is at 30,500. Well, if you see the chart support and resistance in our open interest support and resistance, then you will not find much of the difference. Okay, this both support and resistance will not have much difference. It will be somewhat nearby because whoever is making the positions on option chain, they are also seeing the chart. Whatever positions they are making in option chain based on the chart analysis only. That's why I do the chart analysis as well, so that you can find clear picture. That is what my opinion is. Based on this analysis, I am taking daily trades and I am posting my profit and loss on my Telegram channel as well. If you are interested to see my trades, definitely you should join me on Telegram channel as well. Thank you guys for watching this video. If you found this video helpful, then hit the like button and consider subscribing this channel.